Subsequently, Mao asked Premier Zhou Enlai to issue a further warning to the US. But because the two countries did not have diplomatic relations, on October the 3rd, Premier Zhou approached Indian Ambassador Kavalam Madhava Panikkar with a request that he relay China's message.
向他说明嘛，如果美军不过三八线，那我们中国不参战；美军过了三八线，我们必须要管。而且周恩来在讲“管”这个字儿之前，跟英语翻译还反复讨论了，用英语哪个词儿把这个“管”这个词儿表达清楚，让美国真正看清，那中国就是要出兵了。
The Chinese message reached the United States later on October the 3rd. However, the Americans concluded that China was bluffing. Meanwhile, in China, the discussions continued. On October the 4th, a special flight arrived in Beijing. On board was Peng Dehuai, military commander and administrator of Northwest China. From the airport, Peng rushed straight to the government compound at Zhongnanhai.
He didn't have any preparation. He just came to Beijing to report on the整个大西北建设规划. So he brought his own大西北建设的规划图，甚至连自己的洗漱工具都没有带。
It was only when he was in the meeting room at Zhongnanhai that Peng learned he'd been summoned to discuss the Korea issue. Peng didn't speak during that meeting. Afterwards, he returned to his hotel room, but he could not sleep. General Peng Dehuai had spent most of his life since the age of 18 on the battlefield. He had earned a reputation for decisive action, but this time he needed time to think. At dawn on October the 5th, Mao called Peng Dehuai back to Zhongnanhai. The two men shared a long history. They had fought side by side for over 20 years against the Kuomintang and the Japanese aggressors. Now, once again, Mao was turning to his old comrade in arms.
He said, 这一仗早晚要打，就是你不打他，他可能要打你。Peng
and Mao were of one mind. Long-term strategic importance outweighed any potential temporary losses, and the situation was already precarious. Its northeast region, which borders the Korean Peninsula, was a key industrial base for China.
中国的重工业半数在东北，那么东北的重工业半数在辽南，就是都是在，就是美国、侵略、朝鲜的飞机和大炮的威胁范围之内。如果我们不出兵，就是他即便不越过鸭绿江到中国境内来，我们在东北的这些工业基地也没法生产。
The situation on the battlefield was confirming such fears. Beginning in August, American planes had been repeatedly attacking the China DPRK border region.
经常有美国飞机越过这个鸭绿江，把炸弹扔到中国方面。8月27号这一天，从上午10点多到下午2点多，就前前后后大概有13架次。 进入了中国东北边境领空，击伤中国的边民21人，打死3人。 然后接着29号，美国的飞机又来，所以从这以后就断断续续的不断，这个侵入中国领空。
Premier Zhou Enlai lodged several strong protests with the United States over its actions.
From an American perspective, these warnings from Beijing, from Zhou Enlai, came too late. You know, they'd effectively done what they wanted to do. They were going to continue to push on to the border, believing that, you know, China wouldn't intervene once this had been achieved. From a US perspective, what could China do? They saw the PRC as very weak, militarily backward in comparison to their own forces. Even if they did intervene, they were very confident they'd be able to push the Chinese back.
The debate on whether to dispatch troops continued on the afternoon of October the 5th. After most of those present had shared their views, it was Peng Dehuai's turn to speak.
彭德怀的意思就是，如果打烂了，等于我们解放战争晚胜利几年，就是我们再搞个3年5年建设，那么我们工业上不会有明显的这个成就，那么军队武器装备上也不会有明显的变化。3年5年固然可贵，但是解决不了实际问题，到那个时候说不定还要打，还要被打得稀烂，与其这样晚打不如早打。
Gradually, a consensus was reached.